Right, congratulations, man. Obviously, I got to imagine the emotions are pretty high for you right now. What's the feeling like?
I'm just here so I don't get fined. Hey, man, years of hard work. I told you at the press conference the other day, I was fired up. Those doubters, when you got doubters and you're down and things ain't going your way, what are you going to do about it? You going to fold? You going to quit? My job was on the line today, my game seven. And I told my coach in the room today, I said, I'm getting tired of thinking of this guy. I get tired of looking at him. It's time to go. And when I hit him with the overhand right, y'all didn't see the kiss of death? That's Mariela, game seven, Houston Rockets, Houston Legacy. I had to hit him with that, man, because, oh, man. Tweet about that, man. All them guys that said I shouldn't be here, all them little, man, Twitter fingers. Talk about that, man. Give me some respect, man, because I got here the hard way. No shortcuts, nothing about it, nothing but blue-collar hard work, and it got me here, man. And I'm very proud.
Like you said, you were pretty open. You knew what was at stake here. You know, so I'm just wondering what that did for you mentally. I mean, did it add pressure? Did it, in some way, was it freeing at all? No? I mean, what was the feeling like for you?
No, man, it's just it's a mentality I grew up with back home. My dad was a business owner, and his job, he took care of the family. You know, when things didn't go right, he still kept pushing because, hey, man, you got to take care of the family. Man, I've been trying to plan this wedding with my wife for a while. I was looking for that 50 G's, man. I'm hoping I can get it tonight, man, because, man, I'm about to take care of that woman. That woman stuck by me when I was down. Because when you lose, nobody talks to you. Nobody remembers that. Before you fight, everybody wants to run on your coattail. Because that's it, man. Who was with me when I lost? When I lost to the Karate Kid, who was with me? My coaches and my manager. My manager told me, don't worry about it, Ike. We're coming back. And I love Jason House. He's a man. My team back home. Oh, everybody in the world, man, but this is for Houston, Texas. Everybody back in Texas, man, because, like I said, this Mexican came to Abu Dhabi to work, man. Not a vacation. I came to work, baby.
I know you're about to swinging and banging, but did I hear you say that you came up with the strategy while you're in quarantine? That's when you figured out what it was going to be?
Hey, yeah, H-Town swinging and banging. Somebody came up a long time ago, man. When Derrick Lewis, I think, fought Big Roy, he used it, and Coach Bob was like, nah, I came up with that. Because, hey, we call it H-Town Swing of the Bang because, you know, I'm an oil field worker, man. I work back in Huntington Subsea, and I get off work and I go train. I ain't got time to play. I got to go home to my family. So I said, man, hey, let's get the Swing of the Bang going. I got to go home and take care of my kids and see my wife. So that's what it all comes about. But, you know, Swing of the Bang, nothing but hard work from back home. But, yeah, in my room, that's all I thought about, man, getting this 50 G's. Because there was no secret. I wasn't going to the ground with this guy. But I can tell you, if he was a black belt, he didn't use it. He probably got that from a Cracker Jack box.
Very nice. Well, listen, I know you're going to celebrate this, and this means a lot, and you very well may have $50,000 coming your way. So, but what's the plan now? I mean, now you got this win under your belt. Your job, you know, isn't on the line necessarily, but, I mean, what's the next move?
I got to go back home, take care of some business with my job, and take care of my family. And I'll leave that to Jason House. And I just got to go back to work, keep training. Whenever they call me, they know me. I mean, if I can walk, I can work, man. That's what it's about, man. That's who I am. But like I said, man, hey, April, May, June, it don't matter to me. Whenever you need me, I'm ready to fight because this 84 C10 Chevy's still trucking.
There were some moments where you were just kind of unloading on his body, too, like a straight right, and he was kind of smirking and laughing about it. Did you notice that during the fight?
Man, it was pissing me off. But, you know, when you smirk like that, because it's hurting you. Because, you know, nobody – he had a high guard. I had to get those hands down. If I didn't hit the body at all, he's just going to keep his high guard all night. So I had to wear the body down. Hey, you wear the body, hands will drop. And you see what it did. But like I said, man, that smirk, he ain't smirking no more.
During the broadcast, they point out a stat that your opponent hadn't thrown any punches to the head in any of his fights. And literally the moment he did, you just unloaded on him. Did you know that opening would be there if he tried to throw a punch to you?
Yes, sir. It's called the intercept. We've been doing it all week. Intercept, intercept. Put something in his face. Like I said, you get hit in the face, you're like, oh, man. Especially by me. It was just a matter of time before that right hand landed. But, man, when it landed, man, it felt good to hear that crowd because, you know, it felt so good.
Weird question. You ever watch King of the Hill?
Yes, sir.
Paul Felder was doing his Boomhauer impression after your...
Man, Mr. Paul, man. Hey, I love Paul Felder, man. Especially what he did after his last fight and how he went after the young guys. Talking about, hey, man, just make weight. Shut up and make weight. That's it, man. All these clout chasers trying to clout chase. Hey, man, put in the hard work, man. Do what we do. let the grown man show you how to do it, man. Keep pushing, man. When things don't go your way, don't quit. Keep grinding. We good? Thank y'all, man. Appreciate it.